So, on my way home from work, I found a puffball. I'm not gonna tell you where, but I did find one. I was really, really excited. So this is it. So if it's white inside, it's good. So I'm gonna cut it in front of you today. Hang on. I'll put it down a little bit. So here's the big thing. I'm all scared. Okay, I'm going to cut it right here. Yes! It's white. So if it feels like a marshmallow texture, it's supposed to be really good. So, I'm kind of excited. I'm gonna make French toast. I heard that you can, I did it before, so you treat it like bread. So I'm gonna guess maybe like a slice of bread, right? So I'm gonna cut one piece of bread. Whoopsie. And oh my God, it feels so weird. So you usually take the skin off. And it peels right off. Check that out. Right? So then it gets all the dirt off too. Look how easy that was. Okay. So now I got a nice soft kind of like. Oh, it's so cool. I'm so excited. Anyway. So I'll cut it in three. Just so it's like more manageable. And so I got a bowl of eggs. And gotta make my batter real fast. And just do a big guess. This is vanilla. Vanilla. And cinnamon. And milk. French toast batter. The last time I did it, I just did the French toast batter, this, and then I just fried it, right? But this time, I'm using the Cornell idea, and so I'm gonna batter it like normal. I'm so excited. This is so exciting. And then I took frosted flakes. That might be too sweet, but frosted flakes, and I'm gonna coat it. So at Cornell, we did this same thing, French toast style, with just bread, the Texas toast bread, but we used Captain Crunch. So I'm guessing frosted flakes is gonna be really similar in deliciousness. Yeah, so I'm gonna put that there. Oh boy, that middle one's almost broken in the middle, but that's okay. So, I'm really excited to try this. Too bad no one else is home, so I guess it's all mine. So, this is my crushed up for frosted flakes. Let me get the edges all good. Okay. Wash my hands, it's really gross. All right, so now I gotta find a home for you. Where am I gonna put you? So you can see me cooking. That's probably good. All right, so I got the stove cooking. I've got my French toast. Okay. Got my melted butter. And I'm wondering if I'm gonna need more butter. pressure. There's not much. Everything's better with more butter, right? Oh, I'm so excited. This is kind of the boring part. Yeah. So, I said with this puff ball that you can slice it like a piece of steak. Like thickness steaks, and put olive oil, rosemary, kosher salt, rosemary chop up, like the fresh stuff, really good, and put it on the grill. That was amazing. We did that already. It was really good. I couldn't eat all of the puffball last time, so I wrapped it in plastic. And then put it in a Ziploc baggie and froze it. So hopefully it's good. It smells really good, just so you know. Okay. So it's nice and golden. Oh, this is good. It's just my dogs. Oh my God. I'm telling you, this is going to be really good. And you're going to watch. I'm really excited. Okay, I'm going to get my fork. My syrup. Oh my God, I'm so excited. Almost done. It's starting to smoke. Oh, it's perfect. Check this out. Oh my God. Oh yes, this is good. Okay. So that's my French toast, right? Almost done. Everything's better with sugar, right? Oh, this is good. This is really good. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Okay, you ready? I'm put the syrup on. Oh, yeah. Real maple syrup, by the way. Not the fake stuff. Okay. So, are you ready? I'm really excited. Hold on. Here we go. I've never had it this way before, just to let you know. So. Oh my God. So puffball doesn't really have a lot of flavor. So whatever you cook, whatever you like the flavor of, like, I don't know, teriyaki or... It really works. It really does. So, I'm just going to continue eating my crunchy French toast with a puffball. So next time you see a white puffball in someone's yard, maybe not in someone's yard, but next time you see one, it's safe. Try it. It's really good. Bye.